Her career, nearly 7 decades long, spanned the course of 20th century Americana. I'm the Classical Nerd, and today we're talking about Vivian Fine. Vivian Fine was born in Chicago in September 1913 into a Russian-Jewish immigrant family, and she was gifted enough at the piano in order to get a scholarship to attend the Chicago Musical College when she was only 5 years old. Her piano studies continued unabated at the Musical College for 3 or 4 years, and then she continued her studies at the American Conservatory of Music starting at age 10. Composition only entered the picture when Fine was 13, when she studied harmony under Ruth Crawford, later to be Ruth Crawford Seeger, for those wondering. Crawford, along with the scrub and trained piano professor Jean Lavoie Hertz, were strongly in Fine's corner, and Fine was always grateful that Lavoie Hertz had insisted that she study under Crawford. By the time Fine's compositional career really started to get off the ground with the first public performance of her works when she was 16 years old, she was getting a double dose of the scrubbing-esque from both Lavoie Hertz and Crawford, who were both disciples of the Russian mystic. Well, I mean, not literally, but they liked his music, and that was the main thing. Once Fine began writing music, she was hooked, and she called it her happy obsession. The Great Depression hit hard, but figures like Aaron Copland and Henry Cowell helped composers band together during those difficult times, promoting modern music as much as they could throughout the 1930s, especially in New York. Fine moved to New York when she turned 18, and she immediately fit in with a circle of like-minded artists. She initially made money as a dance accompanist, because her family was poor even before the Depression and couldn't provide any financial support. It was a brave move, she said, but she didn't think that much of it at the time, because there wasn't much of a modern music scene in Chicago, and there definitely was one in New York. She was also following Crawford, who had moved there just a few years prior. Playing pieces like Salome or Petrushka in their piano distillations improved her already phenomenal sight-reading skills. Before she was 25, she founded the American Composers Alliance, which is still going strong today. She made a name for herself in her circle as a dual threat, a great pianist and a great composer. She studied composition with Roger Sessions from 1934 to 1943, and piano with Abby Whiteside from 1937 to 1946, all while giving world premieres of music written by her friends and her colleagues. Aaron Copland trusted her abilities enough to have her proofread his piano variations, a monumental piece which took him all of 1930 to write, and he even took to flipping pages for her during some of her performances. She also briefly studied orchestration under the legendary conductor George Zell, and she told stories of male colleagues who were surprised when she told them that she did her own orchestrations. Fine began her studies with Sessions, possessing a similar style to both her peers and arguably to Sessions himself. There was a lot of spiky dissonance, and there was a lot of emphasis on counterpoint. Her work slowly eased its way a little bit more towards tonality in the later years of the Depression, and she said this was probably the case because of the larger leftward political shift in her social circle. After this, her music settled into a style that's very free and very hard to pin down. In her mature work, no two pieces are similar. Whatever worked with whatever piece she was writing is the style with which she'd work. The composer Henry Brandt said that each successive Fine work generated its own style, but this is a little bit too simplistic. There are through lines through Fine's work, and one of these is a sense of fun, embedded deep into even the most serious of pieces. She was highly aware of the different ensembles that would end up playing her pieces, and she wanted to tailor her pieces to those ensembles to make sure the performers were both happy and comfortable with whatever she would write. To her, the performer was one of the main stimuli for a piece, which is as good of an explanation as any for the wildly different styles that can be seen from piece to piece. In 1964, she was appointed to the faculty of Bennington College in southern Vermont, where she taught until she retired in 1987. The classes she taught included an experimental course, where she taught composition to those who were musically illiterate, much in the same way that painting is taught in large groups to people who don't know how to paint. From 1969 onwards, she intentionally stopped composing at the piano, preferring instead to just use her inner ear, and pursuant to this, she stopped writing piano reductions of her pieces. She continued composing until she was killed in a car crash in March of 2000, at the age of 86. Fine averaged a little over 2 pieces per year, and although she wrote in all styles and in all genres, her main claim to fame was in chamber music and in vocal music. She was not fond of revising a work once completed and performed. She preferred to take what she learned from that piece and just apply it to the next piece that she would write. She said that, looking back, it was fortunate for her to be able to study under a female composer, and that she didn't think of Crawford as a role model back in the day, but she really was. It instilled in her a sense of adventurousness. In her words, a sense of being far out.
Groovy.
In her compositional maturity, she retained her early penchant for counterpoint, while writing music that she described as freely tonal and atonal at the same time. Yet whenever she was asked of exactly how she wanted to be remembered, she never mentioned her music at all. Just her children and her grandchildren, with whom she had collaborated on various musical projects.